Hold the port!
On port, mate!
Helm's on over, sir.
Helm, hold the port, sir!
The scriptures declare that it is appointed for humans once to die, and after that the judgment. Every single man and woman has an appointment with death. From 67 AD, when this verse was written, until 1800, many generations of human beings were born, and not one of them is still alive today. Most of us have known others who have died. A grandparent, a parent, a spouse, or even a child. My own precious wife of only 2 years died shortly after giving birth to my precious daughter just 6 years ago. Humans die. But some of you have lived like you would never die. You've done everything you could to avoid giving even the slightest thought to your appointment with death. But alas, the time has come. You must give thought to it now. We were told that this great liner was unsinkable. When we got onto this ship, we entrusted our lives to it. Each of us put our faith in it. And up until the last couple of hours, we all felt completely safe. We took little or no notice of the fact that there weren't even enough lifeboats for the half of us. Indeed, even as our ship struck that iceberg, most of us were fast asleep in our cabins. Some of you were dreaming about a new life in the new world. But now we're very much awake. We have put our loved ones on the lifeboats. I myself put my 6-year-old daughter Nina on lifeboat 11. And now the lifeboats have gone. There are only a few collapsible boats left. Soon this great ship, the Titanic, will plunge to the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean. In the next 20 minutes, most of us will find ourselves floating in the freezing cold waters, hoping desperately for rescue. Regrettably, there are no ships here to deliver us at present. Let us hope they come, but we must reckon with the likelihood that they will not. It is appointed for humans once to die, and after that, the judgment. You, unlike many others, have an opportunity to make last-minute preparations for your death and what happens thereafter. For that, we should be very grateful. Within the next hour or so, most of us will find ourselves dead and destined for a face-to-face encounter with God, our Creator and our Judge. Does that thought fill you with dread or joy? When you stand before Him, what verdict will He issue concerning you? What will your final destiny be? In our hearts, we all know, don't we? We've so often been selfish and proud. We've made gods of ourselves, rather than giving due honor and worship to the one true God. We put other things before God, our wealth, our talents, our pleasure, our family, our friends. The Apostle Paul wrote that all humans have done wrong and fall short of the required standard, and so stand guilty before God and condemned. Not one human in and of themselves meets the standard to secure a favorable verdict from the divine judge. There is therefore no chance that we will be judged innocent. Truly God, if He's just, and we know He is, will have no choice but to judge us guilty. But as dire as our plight is, there is a solution. And that is why I am here. 3 times in my life now. When I was 2, when I was 26, when I was 32, God rescued me from drowning. And I have no doubt that a major reason he did so was that he wanted me to speak with you his word tonight. Indeed, a dear friend of mine had a premonition that disaster would strike the Titanic on its maiden voyage, and he pled with me not to travel on it. He even offered to pay my ticket if I would only delay my trip. But I told him that I was not about to run away from danger, and that if disaster struck, I would be ready. And so I am. I firmly believe that God wanted me here to prepare you for your death and your judgment. The good news I bring to you is that God has done for you what you couldn't. He knew you could never in and of yourself meet the standard, but he sent his son Jesus to deliver us from our spiritual predicament. Jesus willingly came and he laid down his life for us on the cross. He took upon himself all of our guilt and our shame. For God loved the world so much that he gave his one and only Son. He did this so that any who put their trust in him wouldn't perish, but would enjoy true life now and forever. What amazing love. What sweet, consuming, constraining, heart-piercing love. Oh, how earnestly he yearns for your company. Did you hear what it said? Any who put their trust in him, any, that includes you, he loves you. No matter how sordid your life has been, no matter how self-righteous you've been, no matter how much you ignored him or even blasphemed him. The Apostle Peter proclaimed almost 1900 years ago, "Put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved." The way of salvation has not changed. If you're to benefit from what Jesus did on the cross, if you're to receive the forgiveness he makes available, you must put your trust in him, completely in him, only in him. You need to bank 100% on Jesus and what he did to deliver you from your guilt. He loves you so much. And unlike this great liner, he's completely worthy of your trust. And if you do put your trust in Jesus, when you stand before God in just a little while, all you have to do is point to Jesus. Because through his cross, he got rid of your wrongs and your guilt. Because of what he did, you can face the divine judge with confidence, knowing that he'll render you a favorable verdict and let you enjoy everlasting life. When Jesus rose from the dead, you see, it was a decisive proof that God accepted his sacrifice on behalf of every single person who trusts in him, and that he will render a favorable verdict at the final judgment. All God asks each of you is that you receive his free gift of deliverance. He's near, so very near that he can hear your inmost thoughts. So near that you can speak to him, express your sorrow to him for living independently of him, and put your faith in him. And if you do, as soon as your lungs inhale their final breath, and your heart ceases its beating, and you pass from this earthly realm, you'll find yourselves welcomed into his warm and loving presence to enjoy everlasting peace and joy in his company. The time is short. By all means, do everything you can to save your life and the lives of others. But for goodness sake, give first priority to your soul. It is appointed for humans once to die, and after that, the judgment. But trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved. It's that simple. If you invite him into your life, he'll hold your hand through whatever comes your way in the next hour. And you'll be able to sing, quietly, perhaps even just silently, there in my Father's home, safe and at rest, there in my Savior's love, perfectly blessed, age after age to be, nearer, my God, to thee.